Hey viewers, Kevin the Time Geek 86 here with yet another unboxing video. But before we get into what I got that I'm going to be unboxing for your viewing pleasure, assuming that the thumbnail didn't spoil it for you, I want to apologize. I realize that my content has been very bare bones, really, since I put up that first impressions video of what lies in the multiverse, and I really am sorry about that. My plan was to try to record little snippets of gameplay footage for a brand new intro for my Let's Play videos and everything, and get that all edited together, and also a whole new outro, everything, just to kind of, you know, make it all neat and everything. It's just that when you work 40-hour work weeks, especially when you're at a grocery store, and especially during the summer now, it's pretty grueling, and sometimes it's hard to muster up the motivation to do such things. But, you know, I'm trying my best to just record little snippets of gameplay here and there of different games that I want represented in the intro, and I'm just praying to God that I can get it all done as soon as I can to, you know, get that all squared away. So, and that way I can continue doing my Let's Plays. I'm planning on finishing up Quest of Dungeons. Like I said, I have an idea of where I want to end that series, even though it's a roguelike, so technically roguelikes are never ending. But I'm going to come up with some kind of contrived endpoint somehow to really cap that off. And also, I'm going to try to motivate myself to work to finish up Pokemon Yellow. Those are going to be my big Let's Play priorities, in addition to just doing first impressions videos. So that's where I'm at on that. So, okay, enough about that. Now let's get on to the unboxing. I ordered this from Limited Run. Personally, I didn't get it from eBay, unlike some of the other Limited Run stuff. And this is something that as soon as they announced they were selling this, or doing pre-orders for it, I was like, I need to get this. It is the Alwa's collection, which compiles Alwa's Awakening and Alwa's Legacy, two really great games, on one game cart, but with also little collectible stuff, and it's for the Switch. And you might remember a while back that I actually did a first impressions video of the PC version of Alwa's Awakening many years ago, and I did it on a whim because it's been a game that's always been on my radar, and I always wanted to try it because it just reminded me of like old school Metroidvania stuff, like kind of like Zelda 2 a little bit, and it's hard as hell like Zelda 2 is. I mean, both Alwa games are hard as hell, but although from what I understand it, they're kind of like, even though it's kind of the same world and everything, they're kind of like disconnected some degree. I don't know how they fit together really, but it's just, but there's all sorts of other stuff in here in addition to the game cart, and I've been chomping at the bit wanting this for ages. Heck, I wanted this thing since I ordered it, to be honest. And I was wondering when it was going to get here, and then as soon as I got an email saying, oh, it's shipping, it's getting ready to ship, I'm like, thank God! But yeah, I've been really just wanting this for a long time. Plus, it'll give me an excuse to kind of delete my copies of Alwa's Awakening and Alwa's Legacy off my Switch so I can free up a little more extra space on my microSD for other games. But, I mean, to me, physical media is paramount to digital. So, I mean, I only got like a little over 10 gig left on my microSD, so I'm not exactly hurting, but at the same time, with some of the bigger games that are coming out lately, especially since Limited Run announced they're going to be releasing a physical thing of Doom Eternal for Switch, when id Software decided in their infinite wisdom not to do it themselves, like they did with Doom 2016, and, you know, what are you going to do? But anyway, enough of my ramblings. Let's get started on opening this bad boy up, huh? I swear, sometimes I think I talk too much, but hey, I'm autistic, cut me some slack, you know. Yeah, talk too much, I freely admit it. Anyway, let's just get this bad boy open here and we'll go from there. but I've been just... And you know what? You know, since I'm feeling, it's been a while since anyone really knew I did a video on Alwa's Awakening. I'll put a link in the video description to the first impressions video for Alwa's Awakening. I actually thought of doing one of Alwa's Legacy too, but I was also going to do a first impressions video of Ori and the Will of the Wisps, actually, but you know that didn't happen because. For some reason, the PC version hadn't received that big patch yet, so it was a little... Oh, okay, it's one of those boxes that kind of opens up like this. Okay, yeah, it's like opening up like a jigsaw puzzle. Got it. Okay. Ouch, you get. Come on. There we go. Yep. Oh. Yep, here's the game itself right here, with the two games in there. I love the fact that in the little illustration thing, the little title of the game, if you look carefully at it, at least I've noticed, the title of the game is in the middle, but if you look at it here, it's at the top like standard Switch things are in the US. So that's kind of neat. But yeah. I've been wanting this for a while. God. Alright, let's see here. And then... Looks like a... Oh, it's a USB drive with the soundtracks for both games on it. That's kind of cool. Although, how much are you willing to bet in the case of some things like this, they're not removable. But if I'm wrong, I'll put a little call out somewhere in the video to see. But you know. And maybe splice in a few tracks from the games. Whoops. In here. But we'll see. I'm not going to open this just yet, though. I'm going to... We'll see. But, you know. But, oh my god, that's awesome. Look. Okay. And then... Oh! And, ooh. A little keychain of Zoe, the protagonist. So that's kind of cool. Alright. And, yeah, I'm not gonna throw that out. I'm gonna keep that here because, ooh, early sketches from Alwa's Legacy. That's kind of cool. Ooh, and a diorama set for Alwa's Awakening, which honestly I don't think I'm gonna put together. I might just keep it here in the box because it's a lot. I mean, it's pretty cool, but. Same time, I don't feel comfortable doing that. But anyway, first off, I can at least take a look at here, see what all's in here, but maybe not. Oh, move the picture film before assembly. Yeah, maybe not. Maybe I'll do a video sometime of me assembling this when I get a little more space, like somewhere where I can actually feasibly, you know, put this on display somewhere. But right now, I live with my folks, and it's kind of like storage space is kind of finite. I mean, heck, it's hard enough as it is that I have a shelf on my bookcase here behind me that has all my Nintendo Switch games on it, and it's packing up pretty big. So this is the latest one in the line of far too many Nintendo Switch games, quite frankly. But but the fact is, I'm glad I have this. Anyway, but yeah, but I'll at least open up the game, the keychain, and the sketches, and I'll leave the diorama set as is, so we'll just put that back in the box here. But regardless, let's check these out here, just because concept art has always been a fascination for me, especially when it comes to game production nowadays, because I kind of like an idea. I like having insight into what could have been here. Let's see. This one particularly looks like little NPCs and such, and Zoe herself, so that's kind of cool. And then, ooh, looks like old monster designs. This one with the mask here, look, oh, he almost reminds me of Hollow Knight a little bit, honestly. Okay. And looks like more monster designs, and also Zoe herself a little bit, so that's kind of neat. So yeah. Alright, well, I think I'll slip these back in the sleeve real quick, just so they can be, so they won't get mangled. There. And then, set that back in the box. Whoops. There we go. Get back in. Good boy. And, let's check out this little USB drive, because I am curious. Also, if push comes to shove and I can't get these off the drive itself, I can always get the soundtracks off Steam, because I own both Alwa's games on Steam as well, because you know me, I double dip. And also, it's also my way of trying to support the developers as much as I can, because they deserve as much support as they can get, frankly. Let's get this open. Careful. Come on, Kev. There we go. I do like that it's kind of in the shape of one of the NPCs from the second game, though. That's kind of cool. Oh! Well, that's cool. It's one of those with the little slot thing that where the thing can just hide. You can hide it so it doesn't get mangled. Where was that function when I used to have a little USB drive to store a lot of my emulator shit back when I was getting into emulation and I didn't want to keep it on my computer? I mean, come on, that would have been godsend for me. Because a lot of the flash drives, I went through so many flash drives, it's not even funny. But, yeah. But anyway, I'm going to put you back right there right now. I'm going to set you down. And then we're gonna get this lovely keychain of Zoe opened up here, because that looks really cool. Alright, come on, Kev, open up. Almost looks like it's on a bookmark too, which makes it even cooler. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that's really nice. I like that. Alright, let's set that right there. Throw that out. And lastly, the game. I'd be very surprised, honestly, if this didn't come out as its own like standalone release sometime, because it's, even though it says limited edition here on the bottom, but we'll see. Okay. Also, I kind of like that, you know, both games kind of received kind of are on the same game card, because you know, it's just really neat. Well, as far as I know, it's one game card. Let me see. Yeah, it is the same game card. Oh, okay. I wasn't expecting this. It's stickers of the Alwa's Awakening logo, the Alwa's Legacy logo, and Zoe herself. And it's kind of got that rainbowy sheen to it, which I always find appealing. I'm not gonna open up the packaging on this. I think I'm gonna just keep this as is, because when it comes to stickers like this, I kind of want to keep them preserved. So. Ooh, and the reverse cover is kind of the Alwa's Legacy box art, which is kind of almost like in a wider form, and it looks really ominous and cool. So that's kind of neat. And also, you know, the game card itself, obviously. So, neato. But yeah, and so yeah, that's my unboxing of the Alwa's collection, as it were. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'm just really happy that I finally got to get this damn thing, because I've just been wanting it since, like I said, I've been wanting it since I ordered it. And again, I'll put a link in the video description down below to my first impressions of the first game in the series, Alwa's Awakening, or the duology, rather. I don't know if they're going to continue making more of Alwa's games. Maybe Elden Pixels want to do another little thing, who knows. Maybe it just depends on how the second game ends. I don't know. Anyway, till the next video, and hopefully it'll be sooner rather than later, whether it's a Let's Play, a playing video games for a first time video, an unboxing video like this, or any other thing I decide to put on this crazy ass channel of mine. Keep on gaming, be awesome to another, take care of yourselves, be safe, and just let's just keep being good, huh? Because I've been seeing a lot of my friends dealing with a lot of shit lately due to being part of marginalized groups, and It's not fair, and it's not right. Anyway, see you later.